What's going on, guys? It's your boy Big Hero Chris back at you with another one. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe, give me a thumbs up, ring the notification bell, hit me up on Twitter, all those cool things. You already know the vibe. It's Monday Night Raw, Raw's War, whatever you want to call it, kicking off tonight. They already advertised last week that Brock Lesnar is going to be here. Most likely, he's going to open up the show because you know how Brock is. He'll probably just show up, do an interview, probably F5 somebody and take off. So I'm not even going to do too much more talking. Let's get into this reaction. Let's see what Brock Lesnar has to say. Cowboy Brock is back in the building. Let's get into this video, man. Let's go. I knew it.
And you hear the crowd here in Texas, San Antonio, giving it up as the Beast Incarnate is in the house on Raw.
Cowboy Brock is in the building. It's always a good move when Brock Lesnar comes out smiling with his cowboy hat. And of course, the by God bootcut jeans. The flannel. No pyro. Never mind, the pyro was late. Never mind.
When you see him coming, you all together run for cover. He's taking over this town. Brock Lesnar.
Damn, that's crazy.
To kick off Monday Night Raw.
Crazy as in 2022, Brock Lesnar comes to the ring, probably one of the biggest faces in the company, smiling, dapping up fans. Said this quite a few times, like, right now we're seeing guys like Brock Lesnar and Randy Orton probably doing their best work. And it looks like they're having the most fun they've had in their entire career, man. And you have that same energy from Randy Orton, too.
At SummerSlam. Think about the unrestrained.
He legit looks happy. Like, he looks really happy to be here. And that's cool. I like that. I like that energy.
A standing ovation here tonight in San Antonio for the arrival of the Conqueror. But come SummerSlam, it will be the last time, the last match, last man standing.
Last match. Cap. I feel like they're going to go one more time before it's all said and done.
Tonight, but wait until SummerSlam.
Well, God bless Texas. With an intro like that, it'd be rude for me to leave my hat on this evening. I'll show you all some manners. Thank you very much. As we just saw, life is good for Roman Reigns.
Oh, that's Boy in the Tribal Chief. Boo, Texas. No wonder Kevin Owens doesn't like Texas.
Since WrestleMania, Roman's been living high on the hog. Flying in private jets, eating like a king. I think there's an old saying, and it came from right here in Texas. Pigs get fat and hogs get slaughtered. Roman Reigns, you're a hog.
Damn, Wardlow calling being called a pig, Roman being called a hog.
Hogs on my farm every single day.
I feel like he'll slaughter people too.
At SummerSlam, the tribal hog is gonna get a country chicken.
Brock just says and does whatever he wants, and he doesn't care.
He's never seen. He's a gentleman.
The wise man is here.
A surprise for Lesnar. A face Brock did not want to see. A special counsel to the tribal chief Paul Heyman. What a great amount of history between these two men. For many years, Heyman was Lesnar's advocate.
Yeah, I assure you, we on the island of relevancy are booing as well. We've gone.
Don't boo, Paul. Terrible. It's terrible how they do in Texas.
Speaking of hogs.
Well, that's not downright Texas neighborly of you. We've gone.
Crowd seems hot in Texas tonight. Always a good thing.
Despite our differences, Brock Lesnar does not suck. Ladies and gentlemen,
three little piggies went to town. Oink, oink, oink. Are you going to say something worthwhile here, Paul?
You know what bothers me?
Are they saying oink,
oink,
oink?
From the most stupendous WrestleMania of all time.
Stupendous!
Barbaric SummerSlam of all time, and that plays right into your hands. The odds on favorite, if you're a betting man, who are you betting on for SummerSlam in a last man standing match?
I'm betting on the tribal chief.
Brock Lesnar. Why? Because Roman Reigns defined his greatness by athletically beating down, smashing the opposition.
And the Usos are here.
Making them tap out in athletic competition. But we, for 20 years, we defined Brock Lesnar's legacy by annihilating people, by putting them down for good, by taking them out of action, by breaking their necks, by conquering streaks, by ending careers. So if Brock Lesnar has to put Roman Reigns down for the count of 10, that's what Brock Lesnar is going to do.
Whose side are you on here, Paul?
It doesn't matter to Brock Lesnar if he puts Roman Reigns down for 10, or if he's so violent he puts Roman Reigns down for 100. He doesn't care if he sends Roman Reigns
to the upper room,
or if he sends Roman Reigns to the morgue.
He meant to say local medical facility, guys. Don't get it twisted.
That's not a man. That's a beast. That's a hog slaughterer. That's an annihilator. That is an avenging badass that wants revenge against my tribal chief. I'm going to give you my word on something. We are approaching 700 days of Roman Reigns as the champion. And Brock Lesnar, this is one streak you will not conquer. Because
I'm kind of nervous now.
Roman Reigns ready for you at SummerSlam to put you down. If I have to train Roman Reigns to stick his hand up your ass, and pull your heart out through that hole. That is what my tribal chief is going to do to something like you.
Anyway, we could actually see this happen. I would spend $4.99 for Peacock to see that. Theory.
Well, up until this point, I'm sure it's been an afterthought for Lesnar, but it is a very real possibility after the brutality of Last Man Standing, Theory will be waiting to cash in.
I like Theory. I don't care what nobody says.
Brock Lesnar keeping his eyes on
SummerSlam is going to be one of the greatest nights in WWE history. I'm going to take back my United States Championship from Bobby Lashley. And then I'm gonna sit back and watch this match of mass destruction. But you see, after this match, I'm not gonna run down to the ring. I'm gonna walk down to the ring, holding my contract high, handing it to the official, cashing in my contract, and either putting my foot on your chest or Roman Reigns' chest, and then the announcer will announce, and the new, youngest, undisputed WWE Universal Champion of the world, Theory.
The reactions of Roman and Brock, like, who the fuck is this guy?
Well, why don't you come down here right now and let's go?
You know what, Brock? It doesn't matter if you win or Roman Reigns wins, because the way you two are talking about the outcome, it's going to be life-altering. And Mr. Heyman, I have to say, maybe you should listen to Brock Lesnar, because I actually have some footage of my own from this year's Elimination Chamber, where it just shows that Brock Lesnar doesn't give a damn about anybody but himself. He doesn't care about anybody's life but his own. Roll the footage.
That was when Brock killed Austin Theory? Yeah, it is. Well, not literally when he killed him, but you know. Send him to the upper room. Did they black him? Wow. They keep blacking it out. Like, why show it if you're not gonna show it?
To be willing to step up to the beast incarnate in any capacity after suffering through that. That was brutal.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Shut up! Mr. Heyman, that footage, that could be Roman Reigns. I mean, he could be just a heap of human flesh sitting there, emotionless. But that footage wasn't just for you to tell the Roman Reigns about. It's actually also for you. Because you see, Brock, I showed you that to remind you that I didn't forget.
Well, what do we have here? Brock Lesnar comes to town, and all the cockroaches show up.
Call these niggas cockroaches. That's not nice, bro. Calling people pigs and cockroaches. Oh no, he's about to murder the Alpha Academy. Well, big boy. Brock Lesnar versus Bobby Hill. I don't think this is gonna end well. Do something, Otis. Get him! Never mind. No, I think y'all should leave. Good God. My God. Oh! Another for you, Hill!
Against
God, good God.
No one for the Alpha Academy. Roman Reigns, I'm sure, is watching.
Oh no, not a chair, please. Please, oh, good God. Man has a 4.0 GPA, don't do that. That guy was like Bobby Hill, come on, no.
Lesnar is massacring Alpha Academy single-handedly.
Living up to everything Paul Heyman said about him, he is an animal.
No way.
Brock Lesnar, this F5, 330 pounds of Otis, like it was nothing.
Like a toy! Roman Reigns, beware!
Gotta see this again.
Brock Lesnar!
Like I said, Brock Lesnar will probably murder a human being just because he's Brock Lesnar and he can get away with it.
Are set on Nashville on SummerSlam tonight. Brock acting like a gentleman for the Texas faithful, but at last man standing, Nissan Stadium, we will no doubt see the force of nature, the conqueror.
Gentlemen, that was an appetizer for Brock Lesnar. Otis is laid out in front of us.
No one has ever manhandled Otis like Brock Lesnar just did. We're minutes into Monday Night Raw. The ringside area destroyed.
He's dead. He needs some milk.
And we still got a hell of a lot of stuff to get to,
and
Jimmy.
And we're just getting started. Theory, of course, obsessed right now with Brock Lesnar, with Bobby Lashley, with SummerSlam. He needs to worry about tonight because it's going to be Riddle and Bobby Lashley versus Mr. Money in the Bank and Seth freaking Rollins together.
I thought they were going to do an open challenge. I thought Bobby Lashley was doing an open challenge. And okay, that's cool.
Championship flavor.
All right, so right now they're going over the rundown for Monday Night Raw. So, real quick, thoughts. Brock Lesnar is a by God beast, handling Otis like a small child. Otis and Chad Gable. Oh, man. I know I said in the last video that I'm tired of seeing Brock Lesnar and Roman Reigns, and I am, because we've seen it so much. But I can't speak for anybody else but myself when I say that when it comes to Brock and when it comes to Roman Reigns, they know how to bring that excitement. They know how to make you invested in what it is they're doing. So even though we've seen this match so many times, I do want to see what happens. It's going to be a last man standing match. They say it's going to be the last match that these two ever have. I don't believe it, but you know, it is what it is. And also, will Theory cash in? Maybe. Who knows? Maybe he will, maybe he won't. It's one of those things where we just got to wait and see what happens. So, with that being said, what did you guys think of this segment? Are you excited to see Brock Lesnar versus Roman Reigns? Do you think Austin Theory will cash in his Money in the Bank contract? Do you think he will become the new Universal Undisputed Heavyweight WWE Champion of the World forever? I don't know. Let me know in the comment section below. Of course, as always, like, comment, subscribe. You guys take care. Be easy. I'm out. Peace.